Hi everyone, welcome to the session of CMC, Cellular Mobile Communication. In this class, we will discuss about the phase difference between the direct path and ground reflective path, as well as the standard deviation. When we are concentrating on the mobile communication, what is the standard deviation? So we will discuss these two topics in this class. In previous class, we have seen what is meant by Lee model, how we can calculate the signal strength by using Lee model or point-to-point model. So as well as what is the effect of human-made structures. So these topics we have covered in previous session. So now we will see the phase difference between the direct path as well as ground reflective. So here we are considering a cell site antenna of height H1 and mobile antenna of height H2, and the mobile unit moves away from the cell site. So let us consider, so here we have the figure. So from the figure, we are considering the cell site antenna. This is cell site antenna and this is mobile unit antenna, and the antenna height, the cell site antenna height is H1 and mobile unit antenna height is H2, and let us consider our mobile unit moves away from this cell site. Okay, and next, the maximum distance up to which the mobile antenna receives the signal is the maximum coverage distance. So here, the maximum coverage distance is nothing but the maximum distance at which the mobile antenna receives the signal from the cell site. The maximum distance or the maximum coverage distance is the distance, maximum distance at which the mobile unit or the mobile antenna receives the signal from the cell site. So let that distance is small d. So let the maximum coverage distance is small d. So here the mobile unit moves away from the cell site. So this is our mobile unit, and here the distance from cell site to the mobile or antenna is small d. And this distance is the maximum distance, and we can also say that at this distance, the mobile unit can, this is the maximum distance at which the mobile unit receives the signals from the cell site. And here we have two types of waves. One is direct wave, another one is reflected wave. So direct wave means this is the wave propagates from the cell site to the mobile unit without any deviation, And this is the wave which propagates from the cell site to the ground and from ground to the mobile. This is the reflective wave. Okay, this is not a direct because it reflects from ground to the mobile. Okay, so here we have two waves. So we know direct wave is the direct propagation from cell site to the mobile without any deviation. Let us consider that is this wave, and the angle is phi. And reflected wave is the wave propagated from the cell site to the surface or to the ground, and then ground to the mobile antenna. This is the reflected wave. And let us consider this is D1 and this is D2, and the angle is theta. For the reflected wave, the angle is theta. For the direct wave, the angle is phi. Okay. And next, based on this direct wave and reflected wave, we can say that the received power at the mobile antenna or the mobile unit is given by PR is equal to P naught into 1 by 4 pi d by lambda whole square into 1 plus AV e power j into del phi whole square. So this is the equation. This is already a derived equation. Just we are using that equation. And the equation relates the parameters like transmitted power, received power, reflection coefficient, and maximum coverage distance d and wavelength lambda. So this is the derived equation. So here PR is the received power by the mobile unit. P naught is the transmitted power at the cell site, and AV is the reflection coefficient, and del phi is the phase difference. Del phi is the phase difference between the direct wave and reflected wave, and lambda is the wavelength. Okay, so here for our mobile communication or mobile environment, AV or reflection coefficient is minus 1, So why it is minus 1 means here we are taking the cell site antenna as low. The height of the cell site antenna is low. Because of this height, we have some small instant angle. We have some small instant angle, and in that particular cases, the reflection coefficient is minus 1. So for this case, AV is equal to minus 1. Reflection coefficient is AV. So AV is minus 1. Okay. So this is minus 1. And here e power z into delta. And it is in the form of e power z theta. So e power z theta means we can also write it as cos theta plus j sin theta. Cos theta plus j sin theta. So if you substitute these two values in the above equation, then the received power PR is equal to P naught into 1 by 4 pi d by lambda whole square into 1 minus 1. Here AV becomes minus 1. So 1 minus, this is in the form of A power Z theta. So that's why we are writing it as cos del phi minus J sin del phi whole square. Okay. So that is PR is equal to P naught into 1 by 4 pi d by lambda whole square into 1 minus cos del phi minus j into j sine delta. So here, this is in the form of a plus ib or a minus ib. This part is in the form of a plus ib or a minus ib. So the magnitude becomes square root of a square plus b square. It's square root of a square plus b square. So let us consider this term only. So that is 1 minus cos del phi. This is real term and this is imaginary term. This is real term and this is imaginary term. So that is square root of a square plus b square. So a means 1 minus cos del phi. So a square, that is 1 minus cos del phi whole square plus b square. So b is sine del phi. So that is sine del phi whole square. Okay. So that is, so square root cancel. So square root of whole square. So 1 minus cos del phi. This is in the form of a minus b whole square. So that is a square, that is 1 square is 1 minus 2 ab. So that is 2 into 1 into cos del phi, so minus 2 cos del phi plus b square, that is cos square del phi, and remaining term plus sine square del phi. So we know cos square del phi plus sine square del phi is 1. So that is square root of 1 minus 2 cos del phi plus 1 whole square. So 1 plus 1, 2, 2 minus 2 cos del phi whole square. So that is 2 minus 2 cos del phi. Square root cancels, 2 minus 2 cos del phi. So that is 2 into 1 minus cos del phi. So this part becomes 2 into 1 minus cos del phi. Okay, if you simplify this part, then we have 2 into 1 minus cos del phi. And this equation becomes, this is not clear. So, okay. So PR is equal to P naught into, here we have 1 by 4 pi d T by lambda whole square, and we have 2 into 1 minus cos del phi. So let us substitute this value in this part. Okay. So that is 2 into 1 minus cos del phi. So 2 into 1 minus cos del phi. Okay. So that is P naught into 1 by 4 pi d by lambda whole square. We know 1 minus cos del phi. 1 minus cos del phi becomes 2 sine square del phi by 2. 2 sine square del phi by 2. So that is 2 into 2, 4. So 4 sine square del phi by 2. So this is the equation, simplified equation. And here we know del phi is the phase difference. Del phi is the phase difference between the direct wave and reflected wave. So in terms of beta, we know the formula between the beta and distance and the phase difference. Phase difference can also be written as del phi is equal to beta into del d. Del d is the path length. This is phase difference. This is path difference. What is path difference? Path difference means distance. The difference between the reflected wave and direct wave. So del d is the distance between reflected wave and direct wave. So reflected wave distance is d1. Okay. The distance from cell site to the mobile unit when it is a reflected wave, that is d1. And if it is a direct wave, this is the distance. This is the distance, this is d2. From cell site, we have two waves, direct wave and reflected wave. So from cell site to the mobile unit, let us consider this is d2. From cell site to the antenna, with respect to direct pay, let us consider that one is D2, and the difference between these two becomes del D. Del D is equal to D1 minus D, not D naught. So where D1 is equal to square root of H1 plus H2 whole square plus D square. And D2 is equal to square root of H1 minus H2 whole square plus D square. Because from the figure, we can say that this is D1, this is D1. Reflected wave is, this is D1. Next, opposite side, this is opposite side. And this side becomes H1 plus H2. And adjacent side becomes D. Okay. So this is D1. Opposite side is H1 plus H2. And this is D. If you apply Pythagoras rule, then we have D1 square is equal to H1 square, H1 plus H2 whole square plus D square. So that is D1 is equal to square root of H1 plus H2 whole square plus D square. Okay, so this is with respect to reflected. And with respect to direct wave, here we are taking it as D2. Okay, this is D2. This is D2. Hypotenuse is D2. And this is, with respect to direct wave, this is the height, H1 minus H2. This is opposite side. And adjacent side is same, D. Okay, so this is D2. This side is H1 minus H2. This is D. So D2 square is equal to opposite square, opposite side square. That is H1 minus H2 whole square plus D square. So that is D2 is equal to square root of H1 minus H2 whole square plus D square. So just we are representing those formulas here. So D1 is equal to square root of H1 plus H2 whole square plus D square. Similarly, D2 is equal to square root of H1 minus H2 whole square plus D square. This is with respect to reflected wave. This is about direct wave. Okay. So the difference between these two distances becomes the path length. That is del D. Okay. So del D is much smaller than these two distances, D1 and D2. So whatever it may be. Finally, the phase difference can also be, if you simplify this equation by substituting all these values, then del phi becomes beta is beta into del D is approximately 2 pi by lambda into 2H1H2 by D. So where beta is 2 pi by lambda, we know the formula. Beta is equal to 2 pi by lambda and del D becomes 2H1H2 by D. Okay. So this is the phase difference in terms of H1 and H2. So let us substitute this phase difference del phi in the above equation. We know the equation. This is the final equation. Just substitute del phi value in this equation. Okay. Then we have PR is equal to P naught into we have 1 by 4 pi d by lambda whole square, that is lambda square by 4 pi d whole square into sine square. For here we have del phi. So del phi is 2 pi by lambda 2 h1 h2 by d, that is 4 pi h1 h2 by lambda d. Okay. So del phi by 2. So that is by 2. Sine square of 4 pi h1 h2 by del d by 2. That one is missing. Just remember that one. So just it is a final equation. In order to understand this final equation, let us substitute those values. And if you simplify the equation, then we have the equation like this. So we know sine del phi by 2 is approximate to del phi by 2, or cos del phi by 2 is something L, approximately L. So sine del phi by 2 or sine theta is approximately theta. Sine theta is approximately theta. Then sine square theta becomes theta square. If sine theta is approximately equal to theta, then sine square theta becomes theta square. So here we have sine square theta. Sine square theta. So in place of theta, we have 4 pi h1 h2 by lambda, 2 lambda. 2 lambda into d. Normally we have. That is the part, that is the equation we have. So sine square theta, that is theta square. This term is approximately equal to theta square. That is 4 pi h1 h2 by 2 lambda d whole square. Normally we have 4 here. 4, and from this equation we have 4. And that 4, numerator 4. And here we have some 4. Here we have some 4. Those two terms will be cancelled. And this is the final equation. This is the final equation. Okay. And this will become theta square. Sine square theta becomes theta square. That is 4 pi h1 h2 whole square. That is 16 pi square h1 h2 whole square by lambda d whole square. This is 16 because 2 square is 4. 4 into 4 16 pi square h1 h2 whole square by lambda d whole square. And the remaining term at the denominator we have 16 pi square d by lambda whole square. And this is the remaining term. If you substitute these, if you simplify the equation, sine square in place of sine square theta, we are putting theta square. And after simplification, we can get the equation like this. And here 16, 16 will be cancelled. Pi square will be cancelled. Lambda square will be cancelled. And finally, we have P naught into H1, H2 by D square whole square. So that is PR is equal to P naught into H1, H2 by D square whole square. Just we are simplifying the equations. That's all. This is the equation, final equation, which represents the relation between the received power and the transmitted power in terms of H1 and H2. H1 is the cell site antenna height and H2 is the mobile antenna height. And by using this equation, we can also deduce the relations. That is, this represents the power difference, this represents the gain difference. This is the power difference. Power difference is represented as del P is equal to 40 log D1 by D2. And del G, this is the gain difference, that is 20 log H1 dash by H1. This is with respect to cell site antenna. And this is also a gain with respect to mobile antenna. That is del G is equal to 10 log H2 dash by H1. H1 dash is effective height. H2 dash is effective height. This is with respect to cell site antenna. And this is with respect to mobile antenna. Okay. So from this equation, we can also reduce these relations. This represents power difference. This represents gain difference with respect to the cell site antenna. This represents the gain difference with respect to mobile antenna. These formulas we have to remember when we go through some problems. Okay. So this equation is the final equation, which represents the received power, transmitted power, and the heights of antennas, that is cell site antenna and the mobile antenna. So that is about the phase difference between the direct wave and reflected. Next one is constant standard deviation. So we know the standard deviation. So, but in this case, we will study what is the standard deviation when we have some mobile radio environment. Okay. So when plotting signal strength at any given radio path distance. So that means if you plot the signal strength, if you plot some signal strength at any distance, the deviation from the predicted value is approximately 8 dB. The deviation from the predicted value is approximately 8 dB. So let us consider we are plotting some signal strength at some particular area with some particular distance. Okay. And we are predicting some value. That means the signal strength at that area is predicted by some value. And the deviation from that value, we are assuming the signal strength as some value, but the deviation from that value is approximately 8 dB. That means there is some deviation. There may be some deviation. If there is a deviation occurs, that deviation is approximately 8 dB. So that is the point here. So this deviation can also be called as standard deviation. The deviation from the predicted value. The deviation from the predicted value is 8 dB, and we can also call it as standard deviation. So this standard deviation of 8 dB is true in many different areas. That means we have some open area, we have some suburban area, we have some urban areas. So whatever the area is, so if you take different areas, the standard deviation is same. That is, the standard deviation is 8 dB only. That is true also. So when a light of sight when a light of sight path exists, let us consider light of sight path and out of sight path. The explanation in order to get the point, we have some explanation here. Let us consider line of sight path and out of sight path. Line of sight path means from the transmitter to the receiver, that means they can see each other. There is no obstacles, okay? Most probably. So when light of sight path exists, then if you take some direct wave, if you take some reflected wave, those waves are strong. And if you take some out of sight path means the transmitter and receiver are out of sync. So in that condition, the direct wave and reflected wave are weak. Okay. So here we have two situations. So in either case, if you take any of these two situations, according to theoretical model, we have some path loss. We have some path loss. Normally, we know the path loss is 40 dB. Gamma is 40 dB per decay. In free space, it is 20 dB per decay. In normal case, it is 40 dB per decay. We know that value. So there is some path loss in either case. That is 40 dB per decay. That is the loss when the wave propagates. We know path loss means that is already covered in first one. Okay. So we are taking the difference between these two conditions is the 1 mile intercept point. We are taking as 1 mile intercept point. We know what is meant by 1 mile intercept. So it can be seen that in open area, 1 mile intercept is high. In urban area, 1 mile intercept is low. So in previous class, we have seen that if you take some open area means our mobile unit or our cell site is away from the city. And in that case, 1 mile intercept is high. And in urban area means let us consider our cell site is at the buildings or in the city. Then in that condition, 1 mile intercept is low. So whatever the situation, that means if the cell site is away from the city, if the cell site is in the city, that is if the cell site is in the city, that means intercept point is high or intercept point is low. The standard deviation is same. The standard deviation obtained from the measured data remains the same. If you take different curves, we know how to draw the path loss curve. How to draw the path loss curve? How to draw the path loss curve? So if you take 1 mile intercept, how we can draw the path loss curve? We can recognize the low spots and high spots at 1 mile intercept from our cell site antenna. We should recognize low spots and high spots. After all, recognizing the low spots and high spots, then we can take the mean value. And that mean value represents the point at 1 mile intercept. So 1 mile intercept to 10 mile intercept, we are taking the mean values and we are joining all those mean values, then we can get the path loss curve. Okay. So whatever the area, that may be urban area or suburban area, that means if the cell site is in the city or it is out of the city, the path, the standard deviation is 8 dB only. Okay. So if it is line of sight or out of sight, the path loss is same. It is a different area, if you take some different curves, path loss curves, whatever it may be, the standard deviation is same. So if you take the figure, here we have three path loss curves. This is gamma 1, gamma 2, gamma 3. And these three curves represents the curves from different areas. That may be suburban area, that may be urban area. So this is the distance from transmitting antenna. 1 mile intercept, 2 mile intercept, 4 mile intercept, 10 mile intercept. Okay. So at 1 mile intercept, the path loss curve is like this. And the standard deviation is 8 dB. And as well as at 2 mile intercept, the standard deviation is same. At 10 mile intercept also, the standard deviation is same. So even the distance is large from the cell site, or even we are closer to the cell site, that is we are at our mobile unit is at this position, or our mobile unit at this position, whatever the position, whatever the distance may be, the standard deviation is 8 dB. The standard deviation is same. So why we are getting this standard deviation, same standard deviation? So that is therefore the standard deviation is always found along 8 dB. The standard deviation of 8 dB is always found along the radiation, along the radio path. So this standard deviation from the measured data near to the cell site is due to the close-in buildings. So if our mobile unit is closer to the cell site, the standard deviation is 8 dB. So why we are getting this standard deviation means because of buildings, close-in buildings around the cell site. Because of these structures, because of close-in buildings around the cell site, we can get this type of deviation, 8 dB deviation or standard deviation. And the same standard deviation will occur when we have, our mobile unit is away from the cell site. That our mobile unit is far from the cell site. Okay. That deviation is same. Because if the same standard deviation from the measured data at some particular distance is due to the grade variation along the different radio paths. So if our mobile unit is at this position, that means our mobile unit is close to the cell site. Here the standard deviation is 8 dB. Why you are getting this standard deviation? Because of close-in structures, close-in buildings around our mobile unit, we are getting this type of standard deviation. And similarly, if our mobile unit is at this position, that is far away from the cell site, which is larger from the cell site, and in this case also the standard deviation is same. Why we are getting the standard deviation is same? Means because of the variation along the different radio paths. Because from the cell site, the signals are coming through to the mobile unit in different directions. Because of that variation along along different directions or different radio paths, we are getting this standard deviation. Okay. So because of all these reasons, we have same standard deviation. Even our mobile unit is closer to the cell site or it is away from the cell site. Okay. So that is a constant standard deviation. So what is constant standard deviation? That is 8 dB. Okay. So thank you.